do when you walk into an audition. And since you guys are both with them, there's a table, pile of signs, right? And you're told, okay, this one is yours, you're a boy, do this one, you're a girl, do this one. No one, most of the time in this country, no one tells you anything about the character. It's just like, read for this. And you, I want to know, I'm like, how old is she? You know, what has she done? Give me a bit of her history, give me a bit of the storyline. Where is this character going in this production, like this, in this script? Where is she going with this story? And half the time, you don't get it. But a lot of the time, if you are with a casting agent, you are registered with a casting agent. Are any registered with a casting agent? Versatile? Really?
Yeah.
No. Why? Seriously, why?
That's why we should just start that day. You know, just get them to register with us.
Yeah. Because I'll tell you what, I mean, Njoki will tell you, because as a producer, you're not going to call an actor. I'm not going to go through Excel document after Excel document with names and numbers of actors that I've collected over the years. I can't remember what you look like. I will call Onesma, so I will call Ray or Oliver and tell them, come and give you what I'm looking for. That's the same thing all producers and directors will do. They will give a brief to a casting agent, and these are the characters they're looking for. Age, character description, a bit about the character bible, a bit about what this person is going to be doing, you know, the description of the story. And then that agent will call people that he thinks are suitable for that role. So if you're all actors, how do you hear about auditions?
Actually, this is part of the answer to the question he asked about exposure. Maybe you're hearing too much of what people are saying, that the casting agencies are only stealing money from people, so you don't go there. But how are you going to get exposed? You still need to go there.
Mm-hmm.
Because we producers don't go to individuals, don't put adverts on the shopping malls. We call the casting agents.
It's so much easier. Because if you put up a poster saying, I'm auditioning for... How many of you went for an audition that was held at the National Theatre about a month ago that had thousands upon thousands of people? That the queue was endless. Yeah? Because it was an open audition. That means I'm going to be sitting here watching 5,000 people go through. I mean, at some point, after 2 hours, I shut off. As opposed to next door, still at the National Theatre, a casting agent had been given a description of what roles the director was looking for, what character the director was looking for. And she called 10 people for this role, 15 people for this role, 30 people for this role. So you're not queuing there from 8 o'clock to 5 o'clock with no idea what you're doing, because I have no time as a director, I have no time as a producer to come and individually explain to you who this character is, make you understand. And I have no patience, finally, at the end of the day, when you are in my room, in the audition room, to explain anything to you. I'm tired. I'm bored, I'm exhausted. So the number one thing that you have to do in this industry, especially now that it's growing, it's expanding, hook up with a casting agent. Sign up for casting. They will take your money. The government takes our money also. You know, they withhold in tax, they still have to pay more taxes. But they will get you into the audition and they'll help you wear this. They're looking for a 34-year-old woman, so if you a 34-year-old mother of three who's going through, I don't know, poverty, lives in Kibera. So if you turn up looking like that, turn up, beautiful lady, you.
She's wondering.
Can you sell it? You can't see poverty on your heel, you know? You don't have to be a poor person, but you can actually play around with your costume, with your hair, with your makeup, so that you physically fit the description of this role that you're coming to audition for. So that's one of the things that I would advise you to do. If you're not with a casting agent, just be on the ground so you know when auditions are happening. So you're not the actor who's sitting at home, which is what I did for many years, wondering why I'm not being called for auditions. how many people could possibly have my number really? Even if they did have my number, will they remember me? Will they go, oh yeah, there was Nini. I'm dealing with so much preparation. I'm not going to remember there was a Nini who I should call for an audition. So even if you don't want to sign up with a casting agent forever, give it, say I'm going to sign up with you for 6 months. After that, I'm on my own. I did that with Wacera, which is the only agency back then. Now there's so many. And I'll tell you the guys who are being used right now.
Why don't you bring this coming in several, to be honest?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oliver, versatile. He's used for, I think, almost all the production houses will call Oliver to give him a brief about what they're looking for. You know versatile, right? If you need that his contact, I will give it to you at the end of this, you know, this day. There's Onesimus.
Artistica,
yes. That's another guy who's being used quite a bit right now. Those are the two I know.
Do you know, I think for me, when in several productions, those are the two we've used. We have used Roma Agency, but I don't know how much it's happening now. Yeah, Roma as well. Those are the three because, sorry, I'm talking from the side. I felt it's not enough to have one casting agent or director when making a production of the magnitude, of changes, and I think changes has been the biggest. Because at times I would have as many as 30, 40 extras, leave alone the heroes, and I think the cost at times I would have 160 all put together. So there's no way anyone casting agent provide me. So I was working with two at the minimum, literally. Oliver used to literally bring them in a bus, literally, inspect them, see how they're dressed, because also for the first time, that we said, give us 4 or 10 office looking people, girls who look 19, 20 years old, and then because if you don't look like you're wearing, look like office people, they are all wearing black suits. So I rushed home and I brought scarves and whatever to kind of break their black color. But now when we're looking for the casting agent, we also want somebody who, when we say office, he's inspecting how people have dressed, so they are not like whatever. So when he brings them, they're not sending them back. There's no time to send them back. But we start working on our work. Let me also say something you touched on when you're saying that if you're wearing whatever you look, people might see you. You cannot be that. But one of the things I learned about casting is don't go to what we call it typecast. You know, like I look at you, I see. Let's say for one of the topics was the African Americans who go with their hair plaited, who go with their braids and whatever. And the advice always was it is safer to be as neutral as possible. If you don't have enough information on the role, and for some reason you couldn't get, then be neutral. Let's say a beautiful lady with blonde hair, but you might find she's beautiful, she's got great hair, and I like the color that blends very well with your skin. But chances are, if she's going to audition, she hasn't been given enough brief, she might want to hide there, either dye black for the baby, or do something, because she's too modern, she's too flashy, she's too, when I say flashy, I mean in vogue, you know? And probably, what about you wanted a character who look away? You see now, her being nice, her being great has what the day is now. So keep that in mind. If you don't know, because we producers, most of us are so bad, we do not give people adequate proof. So please, safe. Don't go extreme with your best control, best makeup, overdo everything. Because you've already said you might look at all of them. So if this is not available, it's excellent.